A sex scandal involving the aid agency Oxfam in the UK is deepening and threatening to spread across other sectors of the industry. An Australian who worked in aid at the United Nations has warned that paedophiles are infiltrating charities to take advantage of the disadvantaged in developing countries. The British minister in charge is bringing in the National Crime Agency, as Europe correspondent Lisa Miller reports.
An impoverished nation at its most vulnerable. An earthquake had killed 230,000 people in Haiti. International aid workers flooded in, among them predators using survivors for sex.
When we think of a sex tourist, we think of someone who pays their own way to go to Thailand, Cambodia, etc. What makes it even worse for those who choose to go to the aid world is they're doing it on your dime.
The government has warned it will cut funding to Oxfam if it cannot fully explain its handling of reports of sexual misconduct by aid workers in Haiti.
An avalanche of headlines started with the exposure of this man, Roland Van Hauwemeiren, a senior Oxfam leader who allegedly held wild sex parties with prostitutes and other staff at the villa rented by the charity, against UN guidelines and Oxfam's own code of conduct. It's alleged some of the girls were as young as 14. And worse, it appears Oxfam knew he had a track record in Chad. But instead of referring him to authorities, he was allowed to resign.
We didn't act on it, and more significantly, we then allowed him, because they weren't formal complaints, we allowed him to move on to another post, and that was our failing.
Another agency took him on in Bangladesh with no idea of his past.
Well, I think it's a complete betrayal of both the people that Oxfam were there to help and also the people that sent them there to do that job. It's a scandal.
It is an amazing charity that I've worked with for many, many years, and
a scandal that's costing Oxfam dearly. Movie star Minnie Driver has quit as its ambassador. "I'm devastated," she wrote. "Devastated by the response of an organisation that I've been raising awareness for since I was 9 years old."
People are absolutely stunned to see that this has been going on two, three decades. This is not Oxfam. This is the entire industry.
Andrew MacLeod knows because he's an insider, a former senior UN worker and the founder of a charity set up to fight sex abuse in the sector. He calculates there could have been 60,000 victims over the years. And it's getting worse with the crackdown on paedophilia in Western countries. Perpetrators look for easier targets.
The aid industry is a magnet for two types of people. The aid industry is a magnet for people who really want to do good, who really want to make the world better. But it's also a magnet for the creeps who want access to children to do their horrible things. And the aid industry, until today, has not put the right filters in place.
The Haitian people have shown remarkable determination. And this is your opportunity to do something to make a lasting difference.
Foreign aid is a huge industry, and agencies like these have big budgets. Oxfam's in Britain alone is $700 million a year, and countries rely on them in times of crisis. Elizabeth Chamberlain is the head of policy at the National Council for Voluntary Organisations, a 100-year-old umbrella group that counts Oxfam as a member.
When charities are delivering aid, they are working in extreme situations, in extreme circumstances, in very difficult countries, in situations of emergency, and that does pose particular challenges that we, as I say, we are all committed to address.
But there are no excuses, are there?
I don't think there are any excuses, and I don't think us trying to understand what the causes may be or what some of the causes may be are excuses. It's trying to understand what can we do to address these issues.
But Andrew MacLeod says charities have had plenty of time to take action and police need to be called in.
If we want to send the signal to the predatory pedophiles that the aid industry is no longer a soft touch, we need to tell them quite clearly, if you come into this industry, you will be caught and you will be prosecuted.
Others have suggested forcing charities to go public with the allegations against their staff.
Transparency is actually one of the answers. And interestingly, Oxfam has led on transparency when it comes to these things. They are one of the most transparent organisations when it comes to reporting their annual report that is submitted to the Charity Commission here in England reveals.
But they weren't very transparent with this, because at the time they put out a statement and said six people had gone from Haiti, but they didn't go into the details, and they said Oxfam wouldn't answer any more questions. I'm sure you've seen the statement.
Yes,
I'm talking about.
Yes, and I think that there is recognition that they could have done better then, and that is why they are so committed to improving even further their practices now.
The British government has put Oxfam on notice. It could lose its funding if it doesn't find moral leadership, and the minister is bringing in the National Crime Agency.
We're talking about an historic case, but it is in some respects still live. They still have information they should be giving to the authorities.
Well, the money problems have already started for Oxfam. If you go onto the website, you can see the apology here from the CEO, and you can donate with the click of the mouse. But in just the last few days, more than 1,200 people have reportedly cancelled their direct debits. So Oxfam has to try and convince people to stick with it and also find ways to encourage new donors if it's going to survive.
Some have wondered if this is the aid industry's Me Too moment after Hollywood and sex scandals in Westminster.
For three decades, people have known about this. That's three decades of child abuse, sexual abuse, rape. In the words of an 11-year-old girl in Benue in Central African Republic, I didn't have breasts yet and he still raped me. And that's what this is all about.